New information tonight after we've combed through the thousands of pages of documents that name suspected sexual offenders within the Boy Scouts of America. And for the first time, a local Boy Scout administrator talks about the scandal. KMBC 9's Peggy Breit is live now. Peggy?
Well, Kelly, they're called the perversion files by victims' advocates. But here at the Boy Scouts, they are referred to as the ineligible volunteers list. Reports about sexually inappropriate behavior in our area came to higher ups in this office and became a part of the secret files just yesterday made public.
Volunteer files that were released are 30 to 40 years old. We have changed quite a bit in the last 10, 15 years in protecting our young men.
But the files released of suspected abuse in past decades show scouting's approach during those times was often to cover up. In more than a third of the cases, law enforcement was never notified. The files were under lock and key at Boy Scout headquarters in Texas until an Oregon court case forced them open. The cases sometimes show sympathy toward an abuse victim, but more often, compassion was reserved for the offender.
Just like all of society, there are those undesirables that are there, and we try our best and have put the safeguards in place to keep them away from our children.
The Boy Scout website shows many safety measures now taken, including required training for volunteers, reporting of suspected abuse, and a long list of procedures to ensure that the Scouts are not alone with any adult. The Scouts themselves are also trained in the three R's of protection, recognizing, resisting, and reporting any abuse.
We strive, and the whole organization strives, to protect our young men.